Hey there. So Frank Cho decided he would come out and he would join the litany of other crusaders out there and decry Comicsgate as an alt-right hate group. Now this is an article from Bounding Into Comics. And before I get into this, if you don't know Bounding Into Comics, basically you should go check them out because they cover things like this. They cover the behavioral aspect of a lot of people as well. You know, say a Bleeding Cool might throw in with this because, hey, this is exactly the message that they want to send, you know, because they too are ideologues and they too are shields for an industry. But if you want a real feel of what's going on and you want a real feel of something like Comicsgate, well, check them out. Now, we're talking about Comicsgate, too. This is not a label that many people self-assigned at first. This was something that was thrown on people. It was supposed to harken back to Gamergate, but really, what it was supposed to do is allow dismissal and disparagement. You were supposed to be able to go out and to say, ah, it's those gators out there, to take away any kind of agency. You know, the thing that these people talk about all the time within language like, say, marginalized, they want to take away all of that. They want to boil all of the people that are involved in something, tens of thousands of individuals, they want to boil them down to one word and remove everything and assign labels. Now, there are certain labels within that that pretty much can't be forgiven. You know, Ethan Van Sciver said there were a couple of words that he could think of that you can't take back. Nazi, alt-righter. Also, I would say language like racist, sexist, transphobe, and on. Those things, you don't get to take those back as well. Those things are not meant to harm your fifis. You know, they're not meant to make you mad. What they're meant to do is to damage reputation and vocation. They're meant to take money out of your pocket, food out of your family's mouths. That's the kind of people that you're dealing with here. They have no substantive argument with this. They just go out and they try to bully and harangue. Now, Frank Cho should know better than this, too, because he's been on the receiving end from the same people that we're dealing with now. I mean, if you look at other articles out there, for example, a very easy one to find is artist Frank Cho leaves DC Comics, attacks censorship of Wonder Woman covers. You know, after facing criticism and alleged censorship for revealing too much skin on his drawings of superhero Wonder Woman, artist Frank Cho has left DC Comics. He goes on through this to talk about a specific person that has caused all of these issues. He says, quote, all the problems lie with Greg Rucka. Everyone loves my Wonder Woman covers and wants me to stay. Greg Rucka is the only one who has any problem with covers. Greg Rucka has been trying to alter and censor my artwork since day one. Greg Rucka thought my Wonder Woman number 3 cover was vulgar and showed too much skin, and has been spearheading censorship, which is baffling since my Wonder Woman image is on model and shows the same amount of skin as the interior art, and it's a variant cover, and he should have no editorial control over it. But he does. What the fuck? I tried to play nice, not rock the boat, and do my best on the covers, but Greg's weird political agenda against me and my art has made that job impossible. Now, you notice within that. He's talking about his weird political agenda. This guy is putting him on trial because, of course, you gotta jump through hoops. You gotta pass that litmus test. Does it sound like something going on right now? Does it sound like something that you're seeing aimed at consumers and pros, too? Now, when all of this transpired, of course, Frank Cho wanted people to stand with him. And of course, he didn't want to be lambasted as some kind of monster. Oh, no. But when he's given an opportunity to do so now, oh, yeah, he not only does that, but he goes out and he calls people things like alt-right. Again, things that you can't take back. In that, he sides with people like Greg Rucka, you know, a BlockBot user, and also somebody that has gone out and has encouraged political division, you know, because he has this specific narrative that he runs with. We'll call it a, I don't know, what was that wording? Oh yeah, political agenda. Does that feel familiar to you, Frank? I mean, when you go through that, do you really recognize that? Now, moreover, you have other people that decided that they too would speak up. Here's one, for example, Robbie Rodriguez. Here's my take on Frank Cho's sketch cover. You're drawing dirty pics face of one of my kids, you know, because this is one of the creators of Spider-Gwen. Be lucky you're never around me. There. Threat. Very well stated. Ah, yeah. This thing right here, very overt. You can see that. No subtlety at all. Be lucky you're never around me. This is a guy that decided to not only send out a picture of his butthole to 8,000 followers and subject them to it, but to tag this to Comicsgate and to Ethan Van Sciver. That's the people you're standing with there. That's the people that you say in this are the good guys. Oh, by the way, you know, the ones that decided to threaten you at one time. But good job, you know, going out and really doing your due diligence to find out about the people that you're talking about. I mean, it doesn't really take a lot to do that. But then again, I mean, why would you do that at all? So what did Frank Cho have to say? Well, Frank Cho said the following here. It has come to my attention from various sources that people are associating me with Comicsgate, an alt-right hate group in the comic book field. Right there. I mean, a alt-right hate group. Again, words that you can't take back. But continuing, as a proud liberal Democrat, I'm against everything Comicsgate stands for. I'm pro-equal rights, pro-diversity, pro-comics. So, you know, I mean, let's go through this. Pro-equal rights and pro-diversity. Now, if we're looking at a lot of the people standing out here, we have everyone represented. You know, we have many a person that has talked about who they are, and we have tens of thousands of people that have decided that they won't discuss who they are. They talk about things under anonymous avatars. But when you find out about some of these creators, well, just go look at them. And also, I mean, I don't really understand this. So people are associating him with Comicsgate, and yet Comicsgate is alt-right. Now, excuse me if I'm looking at this wrong here, but if alt-right means that you're anti-diversity and you're anti all of this equality, then why would a guy like, say, Frank Cho be invited to the party? I'm kind of confused by that statement. And of course, Frank Cho would be too if he really thought about it. But of course, it's easier to espouse rhetoric than to actually investigate claims, but pro-comics as well. So if we're having this discussion about comic books, you know, if you listen to people that were actual consumers here, you would have heard them at first saying, hey, give me a reason to buy. The products are slipping. The agenda that's there, it is very much showing. And you know, you've talked about people's political agendas in the past. Again, Greg Rucka, didn't he have one of those? There's so many people that are espousing these things. I mean, you have things like Sean Hannity coming out of Batman's mouth, for God's sake. You have so many comic books failing within this, too. You know, for every success you have median comic books that can't cross the, say, 20,000 comic book threshold. It's only a few past 100 that really go over that. I mean, it only takes like 50-something to get out of the 30,000 and above, and really only like another 50 to get outside of the 20,000 and above. That's where comic books are now. People are talking about that as not a comic book recession last year, but the comic book recession. You know, we're seeing another. But hey, let's silence the comic consumers that are saying, give me a reason to buy. And when you're talking about people, don't use language like this. But continuing and finishing this, I always believe that everyone is welcomed at the comic table. And no one group should try to force another to their idea of what is normal and not normal. So let me be very clear where I stand. Fuck Comicsgate. Now, when you look at this, you know, you believe everyone is welcome at the comic table. But those people out there, I'm going to disparage them. I'm going to call them things that other people would have called me just a few years ago because I wanted to create something that I thought was appealing, that didn't fall within this new status quo. You know, I wanted to draw characters that would be sexy and to actually have fun with that. But no, can't have that because that stuff was wrong think. Well, you know what? You just turned on people for wrong think too. Amazing. Congratulations there. You know, you forgot exactly what you went through. Either that or, you know, some people are out there making excuses. They're saying that you're being pressured to do that. If you're being pressured, it doesn't really matter. You just capitulated and kowtowed to people that really have turned on you in the past. So again, congratulations there. My final thoughts on this are, it doesn't really matter. At the end of the day, it's good to know that a comic book professional has no respect for the consumers out there that are, again, asking for standard fair decorum and asking for products worth picking up. Now, obviously, all of these buzzwords and rhetoric, they don't fit. Like I said, the absurdity to it, I pointed that out. Calling people that would invite a Frank Cho in alt-right, you know, saying that they're somehow this exclusionary group, but again, they would want a Frank Cho in there. Well, doesn't really make sense. But then again, those kind of labels were thrown around on companies like, say, an Alterna, you know, where a Peter Cimetti, you know, a guy that's half Asian, was told he too was alt-right. I mean, that's the kind of stuff that this industry is espousing. And if you need a reminder of what to walk away from, well, we get an almost daily one. But anyhow, you tell me what you think about this stuff when you see it. Also, if you like this kind of content, well, support it with this channel and other channels. There are links within the description. You'll see like a Patreon link, and you'll also see a PayPal link there. Also, if you could like and subscribe, that would be awesome, and I would appreciate that. We're over 9,000 subs, and we keep growing. You know, we're looking at 10,000 in sight, and well, at that, we'll have some kind of giveaway. So let's do that. And wow, I'm humbled and thank you for all of the support with that. But I also want to know what you think on these subjects. When you hear this, are you surprised in any way? I find myself disappointed, honestly. You know, but the disappointment, it doesn't sting anymore. I mean, after a little while, you start to think that the temples that you built to narcissism, you know, with the narcissists gathering at different tables at Comic-Cons, well, of course, they're going to act like this. All of the people that got back pats for drawing pictures or writing stories, you know, those people, maybe they shouldn't be modeled because of that. Maybe the people that you look at and you think about it as role models, maybe those people, maybe it should be deed and not creation, because when you look at names on a product, you don't get to know them really at all. And these days, within social media, yeah, we get to know them pretty well. But anyhow, you tell me what you think about this. And again, thank you.